Hi, my name is Jonathan Huang. I work at CSMA and I teach wheel throwing for adults. So today I'm going to demonstrate throwing a bottle off of the hump. This is a Japanese style of throwing, or it's an Asian style, they do it all over, where you take a larger piece of clay and you throw in a pot just off the top. It's a very efficient way of throwing. So I'm going to gather and center this clay right here on the top. I'm going to slowly open the clay up, making a hole with both of my thumbs. And this trick I learned from a Japanese potter, where you push the clay at 11 o'clock with your thumbs. If you imagine the wheel as a clock, 12 o'clock is here for me. You know, 3, 6, 9. And pushing the clay at 11 o'clock right here is kind of a unorthodox style of a pull, but I really like it. The more orthodox style of pull is you have your left hand inside and your right hand outside. And a pull is like a very gentle pinch, and you slowly bring your hands up, and it should make the clay wall a little bit taller. One of the important things to remember when you're pulling is you don't want to pause when you're bringing both of your hands up, and you don't want to pinch too hard. If you pinch too hard, you can pinch right through the wall sometimes. So what I just did was I pushed this little belly. All the pots have names that relate to the human body. So in pottery, we'd call this top part the lip, the neck, the shoulder, and the belly. Give this pot a little bit more belly. Then what I want to do is make this neck a little bit more narrow. And that is done by a move called collaring. Collaring is when you grab the clay with wet hands from the outside. And you want to have as many points touching the clay as possible, and you gently squeeze. The tricky thing is, as you collar, the clay wall itself starts to get a little bit thicker. So then, oftentimes you have to go back inside and do another pull, thinning the wall out, so that you can go back from the outside and do another collar. It's this dance between the clay in your hands and the wall thickness and gravity. And it's a lot of fun. You guys should come and try it. Alright, to finish it off, to truly finish it off, I should take this. This is a leather piece, a piece of leather called a chamois. And I keep it on a cork so I don't lose it, and it floats in my water bucket. And to finish it off, I'm going to cut this pot off. First, making a little undercut with my wooden tool. This is a tool I made with fishing line. And wrap it around. As the wire crosses, I pull it out.